How you doing today? I'd like to thank you for watching Cooking with KJ. Today, I'm going to be showing you how to make homemade stuffed peppers. All right, first off, I'm going to let you know what we're going to be using as far as the ingredients today. First, I have 2 pounds of ground beef, 1 pound of pork sausage, 4 green bell peppers. I use tomato sauce, 1 red onion, Worcestershire sauce. You'll need 3 eggs and Uncle Benny's boil bags, or white rice. And we also use tomato sauce as ketchup. Okay, what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna have to get the water boiling for my bell peppers and my rice. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn the heat up. All right, now once that starts going, I'm gonna go ahead and add the white rice and the green bell peppers. Okay, now we're going to need to take our bell pepper and properly clean them. So what I'm going to do is cut the tips off, discard of all the insides, like so. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the center out. And I just take my knife and I just carefully remove it. Just so you have something looking like that. Clean pepper, and then what I'll do afterwards is I'm gonna go ahead and add it to my water that's coming to a boil. And always make sure that you get all the seeds out before you add it to your boiling water. What I'm gonna do is probably rinse them out in the sink. To make sure that I get every single thing out before I add it to on top of the stove. All right, now that I have my water coming as it's about to boil, I'm going to add my peppers. Now remember, I rinsed them off in the sink first to make sure that you don't get any seeds in there. Also, now's the time to add the rice. I always like to add 4 bags to my mix.
Why are they in a bag?
I prefer boil bags. It's easier to drain the rice. It's better convenient for me.
That's awesome.
Now I'm going to let this boil, and you'll know whenever it's almost about done. You'll see the rice start turning white and get real nice and fluffy inside those bags. And for the stuffed pepper, I should be able to take my knife and it should go right through the pepper very easily. Now, we do not want to overcook them and let them get too soft. We want to still have that nice texture. Alright, while I got the peppers and the rice going, now it's time for me to start making the mix. I'm going to start off with 3 eggs. And they're just 3 small eggs. I'm not using large today. You can use 2 large if you have those. I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of Worcestershire sauce. We're going to use 1 cup of ketchup. And 1 cup of tomato sauce. Now once you have that, you want to mix it really well. Something like that. All one consistency. And I'm gonna take my red onion and I'm gonna go ahead and add it. Now, you can use your normal, any onion, but I prefer red onion in my mix, and it's just a personal preference. But you can use any onion that you like. You can make it without onion. Go over here and check on my bags. Make sure everything's going good. All right, we just added our onion. Now let's go ahead and add the hamburger. All I do is just take it and I spread it out evenly. Try not to get it in big chunks because we'll actually be mixing this very well together with the pork sausage. And remember, I'm using 2 pounds of hamburger and 1 pound of pork sausage for this recipe today. Now that that's done, you want to go ahead and mix it together. Normally my beautiful wife does this for me, but she doesn't want to be on camera today. So I'll be doing this solo. Alright, now that my rice is done, I'm going to go ahead and turn the burners off. I'm going to take it over to the sink and drain the water out. And I always tell that I can know when the rice is done. It's really big, white, and fluffy inside the thing. Real tender. Come over here. Drain it out.
Steamy.
Now here's where I'm going to be adding it to my mix. Alright? And you want to make sure that you get all the water out of the bags of rice when you do this. So I just take it over to the sink. I just press my knife against it. Get all that water out of there, because there'll still be some left in the bag. I do that. And add it. Add that last bag of rice to the mix.
3, 2, go.
Now after I just added my last bag of rice, I'm going to go ahead and mix it all together very well.
Give it all you got, Captain.
Now sometimes you might have to add just a little squirt of ketchup to even it out. You don't want it to be too dry. You want to have just a little bit of wetness to it. Now I'll show you that as I come along to it, but as of right now we're looking very well.
Them peppers.
And also I'd like to give a shout out to the cameraman today, Malachi. Helping me out with this and also being a great sport and doing what he does best and being the man behind the camera.
Oh yeah.
And he gets to eat very, 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 very good food. Mm-mm. Now, I'm going to go ahead and check my green bell pepper. They're almost done, but not quite yet.
Mm-hmm.
Now I'm going to cut up a few of the green peppers to add to the mix. They're always good that way. Sometimes we won't even add a full bell pepper. Sometimes we can stuff them. Sometimes we will just cut them up like that and serve it as a mix, which is very, very still good. Some people don't like taking on a whole pepper. I always like to add a little bit of sugar to my tomato sauce. It just sweetens it up a little bit. Now I just like to add a little bit of mix of the topping on it. Like to spread it out evenly.
That's what she said.
Oh yes. Now I'm going to be cooking this on 350 degrees for around an hour to an hour and 15 minutes. I was always taught you can't rush perfection, and I just always cooked it well around 350, so that's what I go with. If you'd like to try it at 400 degrees and cook it faster, so be it. But I keep it at 350. And there you go. You have homemade stuffed peppers. Now we're going to go ahead and drain it. You probably want to drain this every 15 to 20 minutes. Unless you use chuck, then you don't have to drain it as much because there's less grease. Alright, now it's time to go ahead and take our stuffed peppers out of the oven. Oh man, look at those. Don't they look amazing? Now it's time to go ahead and put the bread in too. Alright, now that we took them out of the oven and I let them cool for about 10 minutes, I'm going to go ahead and pull out a pepper and see how they look. Oh man. It looks so amazing. Get some of that stuffing on the side. And there you go. You have a good stuffed pepper. No. This is where Malachi comes over here and tastes the food every time. It's always the cameraman that tries out the food. So in case somebody drops, we know that we're good.
Oh, poison me. If I die, it's all good. I was supposed to stay behind the camera. I wasn't supposed to come up here. That was not
fun. You're gonna burn your fucking mouth. You gotta get it in the shot, dude.
Get a little sauce.
Oh yeah, you want some of that sauce. I give you some sauce.
What the? Hold on, I don't know about that one. I'll check. Which one? Wrong. It's good, but it is hot.
And you ain't got no salt and pepper on it because I don't add nothing to it. That's one thing that's crazy. I don't add anything. I don't add no salt. I don't add no pepper. All I add is just like the normal ingredients. No anything else. All right, thanks for watching today. And I hope that you like, subscribe, and follow more videos that are soon to come. Thank you.